just come to me, giving me glad tidings that Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, the angels of Allah, the martyrs, and the Sahaba have drawn up in 100 lines and they have come to say my funeral, and then Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam and the Sahaba will escort me to Jannah. Muaz ibn Jabal saying this fainted. The people say Muaz ibn Jabal was unconscious, and we saw Muaz ibn Jabal shaking hands with somebody we could not see there. And he said to them, welcome, welcome, I am coming to you. Saying this, Muaz ibn Jabal was no more. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors those who truly believe and those who spend their life pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah honors them and pleases them at the time of death. So when a believer is in his last throes of death, the devil first comes. And he tries his utmost best to lead him astray. The hadith which can be found in the Tazkirah of Imam al-Qurtubi is related. The Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam has said at the time of the death of a believer, two shaitans come. Al-wahid an yamini wal-akhir an shimah. One on his right and one on his left. The one on the right comes in the form of his father. And he says, Ya bunayya inni kuntu laka shafika wa laka muhibba walakin muttu ala deen nasraniya fa wa khairul adiyan. Oh my son, I very much cared and loved for you, but I died as a Christian. Azab is the best of all religions, so die as a Christian. And the one on the left comes to him in the form of his mother. And she tells him to die as a Jew because she died as a Jew. Imam Qurtubi, after relating this hadith, writes that many pious people and great scholars have witnessed the presence of shaitan at the time of death. The story of the great Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, one of the Imams of Fiqh. Musnad Ahmad, the book of hadith is mashhoor, famous. It is related, his son relates, Hazrat Wafa Abi Ahmad, that at the time of my father's death I was present. My father would faint. And when he would faint, we would think that my father's passed away. But then he would come round, and every time he would come round, Imam Ahmad would say, not yet, not yet. When this happened a few times, I said, oh father, are you shaitan yabdu mink? What appears before you? Why do you say not yet, not yet? He said, الشيطانُ قائمٌ بحِذَاءِ أَعْضٌ عَلَىٰ أَنَامِهِ. That the shaitan is standing before me and he's biting his fingers, and the shaitan is saying, oh Ahmad, you have escaped me, oh Ahmad, you have escaped me. And I'm saying to the shaitan, not till my soul has left my body. This is the biggest test for the believer at the time of his death. The shaitan comes and sees if he can win the battle and sees if he can take him to Jahannam with him. But it is hoped that one who spent his life worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fulfilling his command, the shaitan will not be able to harm him and lead him astray at the time of his death. So when the believers in his last throes, these angels descend. The hadith of Tamim Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu suggests, فَيَنْطَلِكُ عَلَيْهِ مَلَكَ الْمَوْتِ وَمَعَهُ خَمْسُ مِئَ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. The angel of death goes to this dying believer with 500 angels. And we've already learned that these angels are white of face, so beautiful are their faces, so bright that their faces look like the sun. They bring with them the kafan of Jannah, and they bring with them the sweet smell of Jannah. The hadith of Tamim al-Dari states, وَمَعَهُمْ دَبَاءُ الرَّيْحَانِ أَصْلُ الرَّيْحَانَ وَاحِدٌ. Try to picture this in your minds. Each angel brings with them a bouquet of sweet smelling flowers, each containing 20 different colors. لِكُلِّ لَوْنٍ مِنْ حَارِيهٌ سِوَى رِيحُ صَاحِبِهِ. Each color gives off a different smell. And they bring with them, وَمَعَهُمْ الْحَارِيرُ الْأَبْيَدُ فِيهِ الْمِسْكُ الْأَصْفَرُ. These angels bring with them a white silky handkerchief which gives off the fragrance, the smell of musk. And these angels come and sit in front of him, first as far as the eye can see, so that this dying believer does not become afraid. He does not become scared. Remember, this is a new creation. It is only natural when somebody sees something he has never seen before, he becomes scared, he becomes frightened. The angels sit at a distance so that this dying believer does not become scared. This is something new to him. something he's never experienced before, something he has never seen before, and these angels show him their beauty from a distance. This dying believer it is as if he can see suns and moons and stars all shining, so bright, so beautiful, but he does not know what they are. Puzzled, confused. What are these stars, moons? And the angels slowly come closer together, closer, closer, so that he gets used to their nur. And the angels appear before him, and he realizes that these are the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The angel of death comes and sits next to his head. And according to the hadith of Muhammad ibn Ka'b, he says, As-salamu alayka ya wali Allah. Allahu yukri'aka as-salam. Peace be upon you, O friend of Allah. Allah is sending you his salam. The hadith of Tamim al-Dari, فَيَجْلِسُ مَلَكَ الْمَوْتِ عِنْدَ رَأْسِهِ. The angel of death sits next to his head. And all the other angels surround him. And all the angels, وَيَضَعُ كُلُّ مَلَكٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَدَهُ عَلَىٰ أُضْوٍ مِّنْ أَعْضَائِهِ. All the angels place their hands on one of his limbs. And the silky handkerchief which they have brought from Jannah, which gives off the smell of musk, is placed under his chin. And then, وَيُفْتَلَهُ بَابٌ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. A door towards heaven is open. And the angels keep him amused, just like a mother keeps a child amused when a child cries with all the different toys. When a child cries, mother gives him a toy. Mother gives him a second toy, a third toy, so that it brings a smile on the child's face, so the child stops crying, and so the child keeps occupied. And here the angels are keeping him occupied with all the different ni'mas of Jannah, with all the different blessings of Jannah. They bring before him the hurayin. Sometimes they bring before him the fruits of Jannah. Sometimes they bring before him the dresses of Jannah. Sometimes they bring before him the rivers and springs of Jannah. Sometimes they bring before him the palaces of Jannah. His celestial brides begin to play with him. When this dying believer sees all these wonderful scenes, sees all beautiful ni'mas of Jannah, his heart throbs in the body in an ecstasy of delight, just like a bird flutters its wings in the cage. And the Malak al-Maut says, Ukhruji ayyatuha al-rihu ayyuha al-ruhu al-tayyiba ila sidrin makhdood wa tahin mamdood wa dhillin mamdood wa ma'in maskoob. O good soul, come out to a place where there are thornless lotteries, where there are clustered plantations and gushing water. O good soul, come out. The hadith states, وَلِمَلَكِ الْمَوْتِ أَشَدُّ طَلَتُّ ثَنْبِي مِنَ الْوَالِدَ بِوَلَدِهَا يَعْرِفُ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ الرُّوحَ حَبِيبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِ. The angel of death is as polite as a mother is to a child. Why? Because the angel of death knows that this soul is dear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the angel of death speaks gently and slowly to him to acquire the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To acquire the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angel of death is very gentle with him. The hadith states, فَتَصُلُّ رُوحَهُ كَمَا تَصُلُّ شَعْرًا مِنَ الْعَجِيمِ. His soul comes out so easy, just like a hair is extracted from flour. The hadith of Bara states, his soul comes out as easy as flowing water from a cup. And the angels say, سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ أُدْخُرُوا الْجَنَّةَ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Peace be upon you, enter Jannah because of the good deeds that you did. When his soul is taken out, the hadith states, the soul thanks the body. Jazakallahu anni khayr. لَقَدْ كُنْتَ بِصَرِيئًا إِلَىٰ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ بَصِيئًا بِأَنْ مَعْصِيَتِهِ فَهَنِيئًا لَكَ الْيَوْمِ فَكَدْ نَجَوْتَ وَأَنْجَيْتَ. The soul thanks the body, can Allah give you a good reward. You were quick in obeying the commands of Allah and you scorned to disobey Him. May this day be good for you. Not only did you save yourself from the pangs of death, you saved me from the pangs of death. The soul thanks the body, and the body thanks the soul. And then, all the places where this person worshipped on dunya, they begin to cry. Where his good deeds would go up in the heaven, those places in the heaven also begin to cry. Abu Ubaid relates that when a believing person dies, the earth shouts out loud and clear that the servant of Allah has died. And then the heaven and the earth weep together. Allah asks, what makes you cry? The reply, Allah, this servant of yours was such that whenever he passed by, Allah, he would mention you. Allah, he would make your zikr. This is why we are crying. Ata Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah, they say that the red border in the sky is due to this cry. Then, in dunya, his relatives are preparing for his funeral. And the unseen, these angels that have come are preparing for his funeral. Before his relatives bathe him, the angels quickly bathe him. His relatives have gone to bring the kafan. The angels quickly put him inside the kafan that they have brought from Jannah. His relatives have gone to bring the perfume, the itar, the scent. The angels quickly put on the scent and the itar that they have brought from Jannah.